कुछ दिनों पहले बैंक्स की स्ट्राइक हुई थी और सारे न्यूज चैनल्स पे सारे एडिटोरियल मीटिंग्स में सिर्फ एक सवाल चल रहा था दैट शुड द गवर्नमेंट बी इन द बिजनेस ऑफ रनिंग अ बिजनेस एंड दिस इज नॉट द फर्स्ट टाइम दिस डिबेट हैज हैपेंड दिस डिबेट हैज बीन हैपनिंग इन आवर कंट्री फॉर द लास्ट डेकेड इट हैज बीन हैपनिंग अक्रॉस द ग्लोब ओवर द पास्ट टू डेकेड्स सो बिफोर वी गो फर्दर आई एम जॉइंड ऑफ कोर्स बाय श्रीनाथ श्रीधरन हु इज एन इंडिपेंडेंट मार्केट्स कमेंटेटर श्रीनाथ नमस्कार I'm of course joined by Ashish Sinha, who is a senior associate editor at Business World. I would like to quote three learnings from a paper of Harvard Business Review way back in 1991. And this was the time when US was going through privatization. The paper very clearly says that the purpose of privatization and the health of the employees working in a government-led organization will be nullified, as well as the privatization will not serve the purpose of the shareholders of privatization. Unless privatization will be effective only if private managers have incentives to act in the public interest, which includes but is not limited to efficiency. Profits and public interest overlap best when the privatized service or asset is in a competitive market. It takes competition from other companies to discipline managerial behavior. And last but not the least, when these conditions are not met, continued governmental involvement will likely be necessary. The simple transfer of ownership from public to private hands will not necessarily reduce the cost or enhance the quality of service. Srini, I'll first come to you. You know, I mean, these three points, I'm sure you've heard of them in the past, but what is your sense? I mean, we have had a lot of discussions on privatization of banks, on expansion of banks, but going forward, where do you think privatization model will sustain in India? In which direction are we headed to? And where should we draw a line between treating in which essential services should government maintain its ownership and where should it understand that it's none of its business?
Sure, I think the point that you made about governance of business versus business of governance, there's a very, very clear defined role globally. Governance of business is done by policy and business of governance has to be done by polity. And if we keep that as a framework, then automatically wo jo hamesha wo jo sawal aate independence of regulators, every time there's a disagreement in the market, we have this question, are our regulators truly independent? This won't cut off. This is a single market, including US has this issue. But the independence of regulators or the institutions is very, very high. I mean, it's truly democratic. Okay. And to answer your point about what are the industries that we need to be there, I think strategic industries, for example, defense. I mean, you need some government presence there. And in today's world, 21st century, I think it need not be only physical infrastructure. It can also be IP. It can also be knowledge. And how do you transfer that? How do you hold that is very, very important. Banking. There is no point in having 20 banks with substandard size and scale. You can have two large institutions that the government owns, which are world-class, saying that you have to be in the top 100 banks in the world in terms of size and also efficiency and profitability. But in the last few months, the baat chal rahi hai that we will privatize some of these PSU banks and get them into that shape. I mean, there is a sense of little, let's say, optimism that this time that we will get it right.
Okay.
And the last 3 years, I think we have also seen that the government has showcased intent, jitna bhi M&A hua hai banks, banking sector mein, PSU banks mein. They've actually shown intent despite all opposition and got it right.
Showed intent. Now, I'm sure Ashish will have a differing point of view over here with the kind of conversations I've had with him in the past. Ashish, is saal sarkar ka jo disinvestment target hai 1.75 lakh crores ka. I mean, do you think the government is maintaining a fine balance between privatization and disinvestment going forward? And do you agree with, you concur with Srini's view that government should restrict its presence only in strategic sectors like defense?
Ji, bilkul. Dekhiye, isme koi do rai nahi hai. There are no two ways about it. Government, why is government formed? Government for a developing country is there to take care of all the needs of its diverse population, which is economics, providing jobs to them, making sure that there is connectivity, roads are maintained, schooling system is there. So basic services mein, essential services like defense, like policing, aur uske baad business environment mein aap कैसे कदम उठाते हैं सो दैट आपके कंट्री की इकोनॉमी हर साल ग्रो करती है। इन सारे कामों में गवर्नमेंट का होना जरूरी है और साथ में प्राइवेट सेक्टर, हम बने ही इस तरह से हैं, हमारा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में इस तरह के प्रोविजंस पहले से थे। मैं आपका ध्यान ले जाना चाहता हूं बिफोर आई कम टू द डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट पार्ट ऑफ दिस थिंग। व्हाट हैपेंड बिफोर नेशनलाइजेशन, 50-60 का दशक वैसा दशक है जिसका रिफ्लेक्शन आपको उस समय के लिटरेचर, उस समय के फिल्म्स में भी मिलता है, कितना शोषण था। देयर वाज सो मच एक्सप्लॉयटेशन बिकॉज लेंडिंग प्राइवेट सेक्टर के हाथ में थी, छोटे छोटे लोगों के थी। देश बहुत बड़ा था और अभी देश में आजादी के जस्ट 10 साल 15 साल हुए थे, लोगों की हालत बहुत खराब थी। उसके ऊपर से नेचुरल कैलामिटीज वेर हिटिंग आवर कंट्री, सूखा पड़ रहा था, ड्रॉट आ रहा था, कहीं बाढ़ आ रही थी। ओवरऑल द सम टोटल ऑफ व्हाई वी मूव टुवर्ड्स नेशनलाइजेशन वाज बिकॉज you had a model in Soviet Union, in India was very close to Soviet Union, and also in US in 60s and 50s that the government,
that was the time when we were following a socialist model.
Yeah, so government stepped in and did all these things to make sure that the country has some kind of equality, equal distribution, at least the intent was there. So aisa nahi hai ki sarkar sab kuch sambhalegi to sab kuch kharab ho jayega, ya sab private rahega to sab cheeze achhi rahengi. हमारे देश के संदर्भ में सरकार का यह दायित्व बनता है कि आपको हर इकोनॉमिक सेक्शन को ध्यान में रखते हुए कदम उठाने हैं। मूलभूत पॉइंट सही है, गवर्नमेंट शुड नॉट बी इन द बिजनेस ऑफ रनिंग थिंग्स। जैसे पहले होटल्स भी चलाते थे हम, टूरिज्म भी देखते थे हम, अभी रेलगाड़ी भी चलाते हैं हम, बहुत चीजें हैं स्टेट लेवल पे, तो सारे ट्रांसपोर्टेशन स्टेट ट्रांसपोर्ट कॉरपोरेशन है, बहुत कुछ है। तो एक लिस्ट मोटा मोटा एक समझौता हर सरकार के हुआ, ये इस सरकार की बात नहीं है। अगर हम पिछले 85 ऑनवर्ड्स देखेंगे तो ये हर सरकार ने छोटे छोटे स्टेप्स लिए हैं विच हैज लेड टू लिबरलाइजेशन फर्स्ट इन 1991 देन फॉलोड बाय अदर थिंग्स। बट कहां हमारी गड़बड़ होती है, कहां चैलेंजेस आते हैं, वो है इम्प्लीमेंटेशन,
करेक्ट,
टाइम बाउंड इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, कंसल्टेशन, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ चार्ज, इनफ कंसल्टेशन इज नॉट देयर। जैसे आपको पता है अभी भी किसानों का आंदोलन चल रहा है, बट क्या वो सुर्खियों में है? इज इट मेकिंग हेडलाइंस? नो। आर द प्रॉब्लम्स देयर? यस दे आर। हैव समथिंग बीन डन? नो।
बट शीनी, लाइक आशीष इज मेंशनिंग दैट देयर इज अ डेफिसिट ऑफ कंसल्टेशन। नाउ इफ वी राइटली अंडरस्टैंड एंड टॉक टू ऑल द शेयर होल्डर्स, सबसे बड़ी जो प्राइवेटाइजेशन में दिक्कत आती है वो आती है एम्प्लॉइज के साथ। और कई बार हमारी भी इस पर पहले बात हुई कि एम्प्लॉइज के कंसर्न्स रिटोरिक होते हैं। मेनी एम्प्लॉइज हु हैव बीन वर्किंग विद द गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर हैव हैड मेनी इंसेंटिव्स, नॉट ओनली पेंशन बट आल्सो हेल्थ केयर, ट्रैवल एंड टूरिज्म, लाइक दे हैव बीन गिवन अ लॉट ऑफ इंसेंटिव्स बाय द गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयर। नाउ गोइंग फॉरवर्ड ऑफ कोर्स दिस पुट्स अ हेल लॉट ऑफ लोड ऑन द एक्सचेकर एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव अ फिस्कल डेफिसिट्स इंक्रीजिंग ईयर बाय ईयर। Going forward, do you think that privatization, if we take that road, where do we need to cut the flab? Should we make the government employees used to the services which they're getting now, or where is it rightfully justified? How should the government, you know, balance all the aspects?
See, I think cultural difference between the private sector and the public sector units.
Correct.
And general rhetoric that banks mein dekho salary kam. बट बेनिफिट्स एंड प्रिविलेजेस एंड पर्क्स लोग ऐड नहीं करते। प्राइवेट सेक्टर में क्या है, सीटीसी कॉन्सेप्ट है, कॉस्ट टू कंपनी कॉन्सेप्ट है। अगर 100 रुपया आपका एनुअल इनकम है, इसका मतलब नहीं है दैट यू विल गेट 100 डिवाइडेड बाय 12 एवरी मंथ। वो 100 में से आपका पीएफ भी कटेगा, आपका ग्रेजुएटी भी कटेगा, टैक्स भी कटेगा, वो सब है। एंड जितना भी आपका आपके ऊपर कंपनी खर्च करती है, that is loaded on that 100. वो cultural difference है. And private sector में performance orientation है. That you can also get a carrot, but you can also get a stick. अगर आपको performance खराब निकला, that you can be fired. But the PSU general overall public sector में वो माहौल नहीं है. लोग सोचते हैं it is when I get in, I retire. It is like वो जो dream sequence जैसा, life is happy ever after. And the only person who can solve that problem by changing that culture is the owner. The owner of PSU enterprises across is the government of India. It has to at some point bite the bullet and say that, but politically sensitive matter,
of course,
we will go by performance orientation. I'll give a very classic example. There is a concept called military farms that the Indian Defense Forces had, and they've just recently shut it. There were over 100 farms across the country, and it was started, I believe, sometime in the 19th century by the Britishers, so that dairy products, milk, was available at places where the armies fought. But it has taken us, believe me, it has taken us what, 150 years or something to figure out. Yaar, apne paas to abhi white revolution ho gaya in 60s. We don't need military farms. But better late than never. So I have a simple theory. The government of India is like a very, very, very rich landlord. वो जो generally comment मारते ना, जितना दूर दिखता है वो सब मेरा है. वैसा है, इतना estates पड़ा होगा, इतना assets पड़ा होगा, and I think government has started that. The CPSC asset list that they're making, saying that क्या क्या disinvest करना है. But the point that Ashish made is seriousness and execution challenge.
Seriousness and execution, but Ashish, if you understand, हमारे पिछले जो discussions हुए, उसमें एक और problem निकल के आती है government की तरफ से, communication. The government does not communicate what it wants to do, what is the future plan. और इसका सबसे बड़ा case study हमारे सामने है BSNL MTNL कि जब आपने VRS दिया था करीब 80,000 employees को, तो आपने उनको बहुत सारी चीजें promise की थी. Eventually, all the employees realized that all that was a facade. Okay, many of them are still struggling, or many of them still want to come back. They say that they are not receiving whatever was promised by the government. तो आपको कहीं लगता है जैसे कहने और कथनी में फर्क होता है, लेकिन यहाँ पे तो कम्युनिकेशन में भी थोड़ा सा यू नो फर्क हो रहा है. हालांकि मैंने घुमा फिरा के एक ही बात कही, लेकिन आप समझ गए मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ.
जी बिल्कुल है, और इसके प्रमाण है 2009 में मैं रिपोर्टर था, मैं टेलीकॉम कवर कर रहा था. उस समय में BSNL की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस होती है, और BSNL के पीछे क्या बस चल रहा था, इसको लिस्ट कराना है, IPO आनी है, 10,000 करोड़ मार्केट से रेज करना है, 3G का वो रेट्स कम कर रहे थे, कॉम्पिटिटिव बना रहे थे, कोई दूर दूर तक बात नहीं थी. उसके बाद आप फास्ट फॉरवर्ड करिए 2014-15, ये सरकार आती है मोदी जी की पहली वाली, वहां तक बोला जा रहा है, रविशंकर प्रसाद इज ऑन रिकॉर्ड एंड देर आर इनफ वीडियो क्लिप्स ऑफ हिम मेकिंग ए स्ट्रॉन्ग स्टेयरिंग फेस एट द कैमरा एंड सेइंग आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डिसइन्वेस्ट, वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू प्राइवेटाइज, वी आर गोइंग टू सपोर्ट, वी आर गोइंग टू इन्फ्यूज मनी, एंड लुक व्हाट हैज हैपेंड. घाटा देखिए आप BSNL का, BSNL का घाटा हाल फिलहाल में देखेंगे बड़ा अच्छा. 2015-16 थोड़ा बहुत स्ट्रगल कर रहे थे. 16 में जियो लॉन्च होता है, इंडिपेंडेंट इवेंट, जियो यहाँ गेन करना शुरू होता है, 4G आ जाता है, BSNL को 3G और 2G पे लगा हुआ है अभी तक. बातें चल रही हैं इनको इन्फोर्स करना है, इन्फ्यूज करना है. अभी भी जनवरी में कैबिनेट मीटिंग हुई है MTNL को मर्ज करने के लिए BSNL के साथ, ग्रुप ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स बैठे हैं, 6 मंत्री हैं उसमें, कोई डिसीजन नहीं लेते हैं ना जिक्र करते हैं. कहीं पे जो आप बात कर रहे हैं, कहनी कथनी बिल्कुल फर्क है, स्टैंडर्डाइजेशन नहीं है, कंसिस्टेंसी नहीं है, लॉन्ग टर्म विजन नहीं है. अरे साहब आपके पास पहले पांच साल थे, बहुत बड़े बड़े बातें कर ली, क्या किया इन चीजों को? जैसे हमने एक बार पहले जिक्र किया था, जब यूपीए सरकार थी तो इन पे आरोप लगता था भाजपा का, एंड दे यूज टू चैंट अबाउट इट एंड गिव साउंड बाइट्स टू टेलीविजन चैनल्स दैट बॉस व्हेन वी कम टू पावर एयर इंडिया विल बी सोल्ड ऑफ लाइक दिस. There is no problem. We don't want to run that airline. 7 years in government. In May, this year towards the end, they will finish complete 7 years.
You know, Shini, Ashish is an expert on administrative ways of the government functioning and the bureaucrats functioning. Now, I would like to bring in you to understand the strategic version of it. Okay, you said that the government should only be there in the strategic sectors. Now, Harish Mehta of NASSCOM, you know, TVS Mohandas Pai, who recently came on one of our interviews, they have highlighted that the sectors which have always been away from the government eyes have prospered, IT being one of them. Jis sector pe sarkar ki nazar aati hai, wo sector pichhad jata. And like Ashish highlighted, telecom being one of them, 4G, 5G pe private sector ja raha hai, sarkar bhi 2G, 3G pe, because they don't have that much innovation. If you pick up a big public sector bank, the head of the public sector bank is not a veteran CEO who understands business issue, but a retired bureaucrat. So, you know, going forward, where, if you say the strategic sectors mein sarkar ko hona chahiye, next strategic defense sector is cybersecurity. Now, should the government hold consistent equity in cybersecurity as a sector in this country? If yes, how should they go forward? Should they appoint a strategic CEO who's heading the organization, or a bureaucrat again? You know what I'm saying? How should we balance things?
See, the policy around things like cybersecurity, government should be involved. Of course, for the national security perspective, anything around cyber, digital, national security, already on NatGrid, where the government directly holds it, and that should continue. But I have a simple theory. Agar aap private sector CEO ki taraf dekho, if the private sector CEO, let's say, has a challenge of regulation, agar regulation kehti hai, har quarter aapko disclose karni padegi mark to market of all your investments. Wo jaan laga dega to sell assets which are not profitable. Because it is impacting his performance pay.
Exactly.
Aapka regulation hai saying mark to market nahi chahiye, once in a year you can show it. Or if you're an unlisted company, wo pada rehta hai. So I think the same is a challenge with our government entities also. Today, they enjoy the benefit, most of these entities enjoy the benefit of almost a quasi-sovereign guarantee when they hit the debt markets. So some of these entities are so tiny and probably even loss-making, but they will get a better debt rate than a AA-rated corporate.
Okay.
Because uske paas sovereign guarantee hai. But such is the law of the land. So the only way that we can get out of this mess is if each of these CPSC or each of these entities that the government owns, our nerve center kitra, imagine the root of a tree. I mean, itna niche chale gayi. It is so deep. Government ko pata bhi nahi kitna companies hai, kitna subsidiaries. Kahan kahan hai? Land, zameen kidhar hai? Building kahan par hai? So if we can do all that assessment and then say that every year or every 6 months, there has to be mark to market valuation of those assets. And the CEOs or the CXOs incentive pay is linked to that. Fir aapne, aap dekho, aapne aap sab sudhar jayega.
आशीष, do you concur?
जी, आप गवर्नमेंट देखिए, आप प्राइवेट, ठीक है, डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट एक और चीज है. वहां पे डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट में द गवर्नमेंट स्टिल रिटेन्स एंड इज स्टिल द ओनर टू सम एक्सटेंट. प्राइवेटाइजेशन इज साउंड्स वेरी नाइस, बट व्हाट अबाउट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ओनिंग सो मच ऑफ लैंड? कांट यू स्टार्ट? यू हैव ह्यूज, रेलवे इटसेल्फ हैज ह्यूज लैंड पार्सल्स, ऑफन डिबेटेड session by session, government by government in parliament, this is what we are doing, we plan to sell it, we want to do this, no one does. So aap, agar aapka intent sahi hai to aapke paas itne mudde hain ki aap apne pehle ghar se shuru kariye kaam karna aur multi pronged attack kariye. Ye sirf public mein ek image bana do ki sir humko nikalna hai, humko nikalna hai, humko nikalna hai. Dusra example leta hu, Great Britain ne kya kiya tha? रेलवे प्राइवेटाइज कर दो, जिस समय वो 80 के दशक में कर रहे थे. ग्रेट ब्रिटेन का आज प्राइवेट रेलवे बिना गवर्नमेंट सब्सिडी के चल ही नहीं सकता है. इट इज अ लॉस मेकिंग एंटिटी, पूरा रेलवे नेटवर्क. कट टू जापान, वहां भी प्राइवेट है. वहां पे इट्स अ रोल मॉडल फॉर रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हाउ रेलवेज कैन बी प्राइवेटाइज एंड रन प्रॉफिटेबल. दे हैव वन ऑफ द फास्टेस्ट ट्रेन्स इन देयर थिंग. आप, मैं खुद जापान में गया हूं, टोक्यो से आपको ओसाका जाना होता है, घंटे भर की जर्नी होती है. दो तरह के मॉडल हैं, हम यूके में देखते हैं. आपने रेलवे को किया, वहां पे दिक्कत आ गई, कम से कम 5 बिलियन पाउंड हर साल टैक्सपेयर का मनी लगता है वहां करने में. सो प्राइवेटाइजेशन, इज प्राइवेटाइजेशन द ओनली सॉल्यूशन? एब्सोल्युटली नॉट. कैन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया डू लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स विच आर लो हैंगिंग फ्रूट्स? ऑफ कोर्स यस. इज इट डूइंग दैट? आई एम नॉट श्योर. सेकंड, कोविड हैज चेंज द वर्ल्ड. दिस इज अ वंस इन अ लाइफ टाइम काइंड ऑफ एन इवेंट फॉर अस इन आवर लाइफ टाइम. And this government is now communicating, and through its communication, we feel as if like COVID is done and dusted with. Let's move on, let's privatize, let's do. Ab bank ke bare mein jaise itna hangama ho gaya, abhi kahan sthiti hai? Latest jankari ye hai ki abhi Niti Aayog is pe meeting kar raha hai, hearing kar raha hai. Niti Aayog ek report bana lega, fir wo ek company of secretary ke paas jayegi, wo sare secretaries milke usko fine tune karenge, uske baad wo cabinet mein jayegi. ये सारी प्रक्रिया करके फिर आप बैंकिंग रेगुलेशन में अप्रोप्रिएट अमेंडमेंट्स लाएंगे. उसके लिए ऑब्वियसली मॉनसून सेशन का वेट करना पड़ेगा. पैनिक तो आपने फरवरी 1 को क्रिएट कर दी कि हम दो बैंक को कर रहे हैं, ये कर रहे हैं. लोग मार्च 13, 14, 15 को स्ट्राइक पर आ गए. काम अभी आपका बचा हुआ है 4 महीने का. सो व्हाट इज दिस हैपनिंग? दिस इज ऑल, दिस कैन बी मैनेज बेटर. एंड इफ द गवर्नमेंट हैज टू शो दैट वी आर अ गवर्नमेंट विद अ डिफरेंस, दीज आर द स्टेप्स वन शुड टेक. Do it quietly, do it with full consultation and come out in a time-bound manner. propose your plans, propose the benefits, tell the employees this is how your jobs will be secured, these are the steps we are taking. Amendment, aapne integration bank ki baat ki thi, main last point keh raha hu, abhi tak integration pura nahi hua in banks mein. इनके एम्प्लॉयज के लिस्ट अभी शेयर नहीं हुए. अगर आप आपके अकाउंट खुदाना खास्ता उन बैंक्स में है जिनका मर्जर हुआ था आपस में, आप जाइए, आपको लाइन में लगना पड़ेगा. कभी उनका कंप्यूटर काम नहीं कर रहा है, कभी सर्वर काम नहीं कर रहा है, कभी ट्रेनिंग पे गए हैं स्टाफ. तो
इंप्लीमेंटेशन एंड ऑल्सो द प्लानिंग टुवर्ड्स प्राइवेटाइजेशन. सीन, इफ यू रिमेंबर व्हेन एयर इंडिया वाज बीइंग ऑफर्ड टू प्राइवेटाइज, दिस इज 3 or 4 years अगो, आई डोंट रिमेंबर द एग्जैक्ट ईयर, बट गवर्नमेंट क्रिएटेड अ स्पेशल पर्पस व्हीकल टू प्राइवेटाइज एयर इंडिया एंड they had retained the best parts of the SPV with themselves. They just wanted to sell all the loss-making entities, but all the profitable entities of Air India, which was the engineering division, the real estate, they wanted to keep to themselves. And as a result, they didn't find any prospective buyer. Do you think there's also a problem in the sales pitch the way government privatizes?
See, their answer is yes and no. I won't blame the government alone. The government also works with all the known, renowned global and Indian consulting firms in any of these processes. So, and these are people in the private sector like you and me who are giving advice to the government. Why are they giving the wrong advice? The point is that very simple. Agar, for example, bank integration, why? We have had successful integration the last 3 years, but some of the recent ones, as Ashish said, wo usme dikkat hai. The problems of micro code not available. I mean, abhi logon ko ye dar hai ki dividend bounce hoga ki kya hoga from April first week. Rightful worries hai. But point ye hai na, knowledge management kidhar? We have had successful integration of PSU banks in the last 3 years. There must be a Bible available with you. There must be a Excel sheet available. Ye itna lamba list hai. In IT ye sab karo, in people ye sab karo, in processes, in compliance ye sab karo. Why can't it be shared? And I'm sure there is a training academy or a group of bankers, IBA, Indian Banking Association. I'm sure they can take the lead in setting up a task force. I mean, we have a rich knowledge base called retired bankers who have successfully integrated those banks. Get them to head those task force. Get them as a governance model. Na, unko aap supervisory role dijiye or advisory role, saying that the next 6 months, please head this task force to integrate other banks. It'll also open up the bandwidth for the CEO who is running that bank. See, this has been a tough year. Aapka moratorium case chal raha tha for many, many months. Then you had the NPA issues. Then you already had a slowing credit issue. Then you had capital requirement of most of the PSU banks. Is mahol mein, you also had M&A happening. So I think I still will, what I generally say, cut some slack here. Thoda usko space do. But could they have learned from their other banker friend? They should have. Could the government facilitated by bringing some of the retired bankers who have merged banks to help them? They should have. And they still can.
Which sectors do you think government should completely own the enterprises, and which should be the sectors where government should needs to get out ASAP? It's not none of their business.
See, that's a tough one. Today, I mean, globally, you have models where even in the infrastructure space, social infrastructure space, whether it is water, power, sewage, the city services, there have been privatization. They've been outsourced. I mean, pani ka supply bhi aajkal aap outsource kar sakte. You can have a good contract, which is a PPP model, and you can encourage private sector for innovation. But this is a simple cheez hai. Aapka KRA or KPI kya hai? Key responsibility area kya hai? Or key performance indicator kya hai? If you can get that right, you can outsource almost everything. I mean, US mein, for example, you even have prison management, which is outsourced. The government does own prisons.
That's correct.
There are cases like this, right? Usme kya dikkat hai? People will question about the social rights, civil rights, then human rights. Sab questions aayenge. But they've defined everything and outsourced. So I think there are good things to learn in the capitalist model, which is why I always say that we will have to at some point make up our mind. As an economy, we want to be capitalist. Yes, we also have to be inclusive in nature, but it doesn't mean that we have to live in the past.